I'm making welcome Mr. Graham Pugh.
Oh, thank you. Good. Well, welcome to the Comedy Store. Some of you probably already know that this is probably the only sheltered workshop for mentally retarded stand-up comedians. And we always like to do a bit of market research before a show just to find out who's been in before, for example. Has anyone actually been to the Comedy Store? Or is anyone actually visiting the Comedy Store for the very first time tonight? Any foreign bastards in at all? Got one here? Yeah? Where from? Hey, where? Kuwait! Dutch! Kuwait. That's kind of like, well, I don't know. Kuwait's not bad. It's one of those countries that there are absolutely no jokes about. Kuwait. Where the men and the sheep aren't nervous anymore because they're fucking used to it. It's about the only joke I think of. Kuwait. Yeah. Long way to come for a night out. Okay, now we'll do a traditional Comedy Store opening. Everybody now turn to the person on your right and throw up. Right? We'll keep the Comedy Store opening going because that seems to be the most popular. Everybody turn now to the person or face the person sitting opposite you. Right? Give them a big North Shore smile. And say, fuck, you're ugly. Good. Because what we do here, if you haven't been here before, what we do, they call this new wave comedy, which is basically the same as old wave comedy, except we swear a lot. But your role in this, of course, is to be the trendy 80s audience. And as such, of course, the trendy 80s audience does not laugh. It is no longer trendy to laugh. I was watching some American comedians, and what they do, American comedians now, do truth comedy. They come on and say, hey, have you ever noticed when you're washing the dishes, how the cutlery breeds? And the entire audience goes, yo, yeah, come on, get down, woo, we are far out, woo, yeah, all right, truth comedy, woo, yeah. And that's just the whites, so that's what it's about. New wave comedy, new wave audience, and all the acts on tonight are all featured performers here at the Comedy Store, so it's going to be a great night. So sit back, relax, and I'll bring on the first cab off the rank. A man that's been a regular here for several months and a very, very funny man. Make him welcome Mr. Calvin de Grey, ladies and gentlemen. Go on, Calvin de Grey.
Come out here and start my little piece of the act with a song to get us going. This is a little song of Marcel Marceau's latest LP. Actually, it's a bit of a protest song, folks. Like, I don't know about you people. I'm getting a bit sick of all this Advance Australia stuff. Yeah. Yeah, all this, you know, do the right thing and have a go. You know, life be in it. That sounds pretty filthy for a start. You know, things like join the army, meet interesting people and kill them. Or play rugby and feel a man. Any boys here tonight? Always trying to build us up, make us feel bigger than we are, you know. Things like feel superior, fondle a nun. My girlfriend's a nun, nun in the morning, nun at night. You know. Things like, visit Russia before Russia fucking visits you. Strike for the right to pretend to work. Join the DMR. We got some things. Keep Australia green. Fuck a frog. Yeah, no, like, fair enough. I reckon you can get Greece on a Greek. But I don't know about this come on Aussie shit, you know. I'm not going to wear that. You know, I don't know about you people, like a lot of us here are about the same age, you know, we grew up around all this advertising rot. I think it's very misleading, you know. Like I used to stalk Mr. Sheen and see little blokes run around on the furniture. My brother, he got it all wrong, he drank a whole bottle of furniture polish. Terrible death, it was a good finish, but he was all right that way, you know. But look at the stupid ads we've got to cop, day in, day out. things like Rita the Eater, you know. I wouldn't eat a Rita. I wouldn't even eat fucking Rita for that matter, you know. Yeah, they call her margarine legs because she spreads easy, you know. All these ads, now we've got the breathalyzer commercial. The breathalyzer. One in three gets tested. And a little hand comes and picks up a man, you know. What a lot of shit that is. One in three gets tested. That sounds all right to me. That means two out of three can get pissed. I was working right out west, way out west, a little place beyond Cessnock. A little place called Windybum. I believe it's an Aboriginal name. It means fart. And I was right out there. I thought I'd try the bottle of tendon out in there. So I went in the bottle shop. I went, bah, bah, bah. He sheared me head off and tried to fuck me. You know, they're like out there at Cessnock, where men are men and the sheep keep moving. Now I know why God's given us women. That's because sheep can't cook. Hang on. I've upset a few girls here. They're looking upset, these girls. With heads like that, I'd be upset too. I'll get on. Other commercials, like things like fast food. We're always getting fast food, you know. Things like Chinese dinner in a cup. Good enough for me. I eat shit. You know. You run in the shop, you get a hamburger and chips, you run out, you spew in the gutter, you think, shit, that was fast food. What about the other night? Sunday night at the movies, we had Halloween, the movie, brought to you by Wilshire Stay Sharp. 18 consecutive stabbings brought to you by Wilshire fucking Stay Sharp. Do you realise what this could lead to? They could have things like horror movie brought to you by Laxette, so you'll really shit yourself. Or the Brady Bunch brought to you by Tampax, because it's a cunt of a show, it really is. We got some Brady Bunch fans over here, eh? I'd like to see a pornographic version of the Brady Bunch, wouldn't you? Yeah, I'd like to see Mr. Brady go down on Marcia. Yeah, wouldn't you? Cindy sucking him off, yeah. I'd like to see that. All right, folks, move the show along. This, folks, I have for you now, an impersonation, folks. This is an impersonation of farmyard noises. Here we go. Farmyard noises. Where's the fucking tractor? Thank you much. I'm sorry, you wanted an animal, didn't you, dear? I'll give you an animal. No, actually, I'll give this girl an animal. She wants an animal. An impersonation of a pig. Here we go. Pull over, driver. Another thing. Okay, folks. Here we go. An impersonation, folks, of the first man on the sun. Here we go. Oh, I should have went at night. Okay, hang on. Christ's sake. Little sayings, things like proverbs. How are we supposed to learn from proverbs? You know, things like one good turn gets most of the blanket. At first you don't succeed, so much for fucking skydiving. Friend in need's a fucking pest, you know. Bird in the hand shits on your wrist, you know. How are we supposed to learn from that crap? You know, and fairy tales, little things like Jack is nimble, Jack is quick, but Jill still prefers the candlestick. You know, stories like Little Red Riding Hood trotting through the woods. Out comes a big bad wolf and says, I'm gonna eat you. And she says, doesn't anyone fuck anymore? Bloody ridiculous, the whole rot. Now we've got video. Video's moving it on. Everything's fast. Video, computers, everything, calculators. It's all on. It's horrifying. friends over the road said to me, well, we're going to video our natural childbirth. I thought, what a start of own movie that is. Terrible. What we did, we got hold of the tape, put it backwards and saw the kid disappear. And to see that. All right, folks. I'd like to sing you a little song now. This is a little song all about the girl of my dreams, but it didn't quite work out. It's called I Took Her Into the Fog and Missed. I didn't like that very much. All right. Now, actually, the real title of the song is Don't Wait Up for the Prawn Trawlers, cause your sister's coming home with the crabs. When I was a little boy, my father said to me, if you want to be a true Aussie, you got to get into carpentry. Well, I don't like banging nails, I find it all too rough. So I grabbed the Black and Decker workmate and I shoved it up his ass. My country is for me. I'm a true blue dinkum Aussie. Well, Bulma Billy, eat my pie, don't drink my beer or you get a black eye. Kangaroos, didgeridoo, holding cars, my singlet's blue. And I never went to bed with an ugly woman, but I sure woke up with a few. Aru, aru. I'll hop into me holding into the Commodore, I will hop. Weave halfway down the highway and get pulled up by a cop. He'll say, what's wrong with you, Mac? This time you're out of luck. So blow into this bag. I say, I can't, but can I suck? My country is for me. I'm a true blue bedinkum Aussie. Well, bother me, eat my pie, don't drink my beer or you get a black eye. Kangaroos, didgeridoo, holding cars, a singlet's blue. And I never kicked a woman out of bed just to give her a root on the floor. Oh, 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 my country is for me. Thank you very much. Good night. See you later. It's been a lovely audience.
Calvin de Grey. Calvin de Grey. Available for bingo calling and children's parties. Calvin de Grey. I've got an act for you now, ladies and gentlemen. Well, he's probably the finest impressionist in Australia, ladies and gentlemen. The voice of Ronald McDonald, the voice of Fredo Frog. What more can I say? Except here he is, making very welcome Mr. Keith Scott. Come on, give him a hand. Keith Scott!
Thank you. Thank you very much. Don't appreciate that introduction.
This Jimmy Stewart, ladies and gentlemen, when you do impressions in your act, the thing is you got to open up with some of the cliches.
Well, thank you. Oh, isn't it wonderful? Oh, this room is wonderful. You people are so delightful. Oh, stuff the formalities. Where the fuck's Jamie Redfern?
Thank you. What I like doing is impressions of people that nobody else has ever attempted. Really offbeat characters. Like people that I sort of started doing way back when I was watching TV as a kid. Like, quick impression of Lloyd Bridges from Sea Hunt.
Howdy, skin divers. Skin diving can be fun. Jeff, Bo, leave each other alone.
keep that one in.
Skin diving can be fun. But it's also dangerous, huh? So learn to fucking swim first, huh? See you next week, huh?
Quick impression of Raymond Burr.
This is Raymond Burr. You know, I used to be Perry Mason, then I became Ironside, and then I quit Ironside. I said, no one's gonna fucking push me around anymore.
Quick impression of Fred McMurray from My Three Sons. Thank you.
Oh, wait, Jim. Jim, Ernie, Robbie, Jim. Come on, boys, give it a break. Leave Uncle Charlie's balls alone. He's
a little frog in the throat. Used to be a prince. Tell you one person whose image should really change is Bill Collins. He's always doing the same thing. It's all year after year. Good evening. You know, tonight. I'm sorry. Tonight, I have a film. Oh God, I've said film, I've come. But, you know. Ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, yes indeed, one of the classics of all time. Gidget Gets a Heat Rash. Yes, one of the great movies. Soon to be followed by another classic, Lassie Gets the Mange. Next week, Gandhi Sucks an Egg. People could do this from time to time. Like, you see, in the old days, if a star took a risk with their image, well, I see something like Bing Crosby. Bing Crosby doing cocaine.
Ba-ba-ba. Ba-ba-ba. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Oh, wish I had Bob Hope's nose, you know. Ba-ba-ba. Ba-ba-ba. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
Who else? And I hear that there is talk of redoing the Ten Commandments. If this happens, I imagine the Last Supper scene will be populated with old-time actors in little bit parts, cameos, as they do in all those Bible films. One of the waiters could be Cary Grant. Oh, Judas, Judas, Judas. Oh, yes, what a liar you are, Judas. Absolutely delightful. Yes, what a bullshit artist. My God, Rex Jackson wants your phone number. One of the other waiters says,
oh yes, Judas. Oh, you dirty rat, Judas. You dirty rat, up your Yankee Doodle.
Then Jimmy Stewart makes his entrance and he plays Matthew. And Jimmy says, Jesus, I want to tell you something for Christ's sake. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean, don't do any miracles. When you turned me into a toad last year, it was terrible. Thing is, Jesus, there's some nasty gossip around that they're going to take you up on the cross after supper and put nails in your hands and feet. If I were you, I'd cancel Easter. Waste of time, the bunny, the egg. And also in this movie, there would be a man portraying the guy running around writing the Bible.
Pardon me for interrupting you, sir. Excuse me, Jesus. Jesus, Mr. Messiah. I gotta tell you, sir, my wife thinks you're terrific, Jesus. Terrific, sir. Thank you very, very much for that. She thinks you're terrific. One miracle, put my eyeball back in, sir. This time, don't make it Sammy Davis. I can't boogie. I'm very sincere as well. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
And Jesus, of course, would be John Wayne. Who else? He's dead, so is John Wayne.
Listen to me, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. I've just sweated into my goddamned eyeball. Sorry, Dad. Fooled you, man. Ha, ha, ha. Disciples, I want to tell you, after dinner, I'm going on a dangerous mission. I gotta take that hill. So I'll either see you at the resurrection or I won't. Yo!
And he goes off. Now, they spend a lot of money in this movie, so as he goes off to the hill, there's a scene where there's a song coming out of the sky, sung by Gene Pitney.
When Liberty Jesus rode the town, the women folk would hide it high. When Liberty Jesus strolled around, the sinners stepped aside. Because the Catholic Church was the only law Liberty understood. When it came to burning sinners in hell, he's almighty good.
So he's up there on the cross. Thank you. Oh, it's a music lover, too. Oh, I got occasional as a music lover. Of course, Jesus had Mexican for the Last Supper, so as he went off, Johnny Cash was there. Jesus went off with a burning ring of nut. Sorry about that. I threw that one in and I'll never do it again. So he's up there on the cross, and the town leper, played by Peter Lorre, enters the scene.
Oh, Jesus, you're a wonderful man. I worship you. I slobber, slobber. Oh, I'm falling to bits. Jesus, would you please forgive my sins?
Well, I'll forgive you. The hell I will.
Big movie. Everyone's in it in little bit parts. James Mason's there.
Jesus, one miracle. Make Lolita 2 years younger.
Burt Lancaster, everyone. Charlton Heston.
What the fuck aren't I doing in this picture?
Kirk Douglas is a spear carrier.
Jesus, I've heard you can walk across the lake. Bullshit. Go ahead and prove it. Do it now or I'll shove my chin up your ass.
And if he doesn't do it, he'll torture him from a couple of scenes from The Man from Snowy River where Kirk Douglas does the Leonard Teal part.
There was movement at the station. Because the prunes were passed around. Boom, boom!
Everyone's in this movie. And finally, I guess what's going to happen, as it always does with successful movies, American Graffiti became the TV series Happy Days. This one is going to... The religion will be everywhere next rating season. You can just bet your bottom... Thing is, religion will be in all forms, too. It'll be religious game shows. Saviour of the century.
Hello, hello, good evening. Hi, Delveen. It's Tony Barabbas here.
There'll be religious soap operas, Sons and Gomorrah. Religious current events, 60 Minutes, 40 Days and 40 Nights. The biggie will be religious sport. Tony Gregg will commentate cricket matches played by lepers.
Well, it may not be the best game that I've ever seen, but stumps everywhere. Truly. Wonderful. There he goes up to bowl. He's got, whoops, sorry, had a wonderful arm. And look, LBW.
And finally, you can guarantee that Grundy's or one of the production companies will get a serial going, a religious soap opera, from the Bible in chronological order. It will be narrated by Orson Welles.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This Bible was copied with a Nashua copy machine. Thank you, and I read from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, there was emphysema. In the beginning, there was God.
Hello, world. This is John Laws. And I am God. My radio program and in all walks of life, I am God Laws. I created the world in 6 days in a Mrs. Niebel kitchen.
This is a quick history of all of the great cartoon stars in one sentence, and it goes like this. Oh, the world owes me a living. Hi there, Mouseketeers. Oh, Pluto, stop it.
What's up, Doc?
Be very, very quiet. I'm after that wesky whittle Bugs Bunny.
Oh, you're despicable. You're despicable.
Hates rabbits. Doodah, keep your eye on the ball, boy. Eyeball, that is.
Fair enough, Pluto. Who's got me spinach olive oil?
Oh, my George Waldo, my boy. Oh, Magoo, you silly old fart.
Mr. Ranger, sir, here in Jellystone National Park. They just made a Big Mac out of boo-boo-chi, aye?
You know, like, I really hate them miserable meat-type nieces to pieces, you know? I mean, thank you. Like, Pixie and Dixie, give me the shits, and that's all there is to it, you know?
Hey, Fred, they got a mammoth sale downtown, Fred.
I don't need a mammoth, Barney, I got a brontosaurus.
JTC, Officer Dibble's after us, TC. Better piss off, TC.
Oh dear, oh Lippy, oh shit a brick.
Hey Rocky, watch me pull a rabbit out of my hat, Rock, nothing up my sleeve, presto!
Dudley Do Right of the Mounties here, Snidely Whiplash. I arrest you in the name of the RCMP camp for having intercourse with this man.
Roger Ramjet and the American Eagle Squadron. Yankee Doodle Dandy and all my solenoid robots.
Heavens to Murgatroyd. I want to thank you. You've been a terrific audience, even. Good night.
That's all, folks. Thank you very much and good night. Thank you, one and all. You've been terrific. Thank you.
Keith Scott.
Keith Scott. Great stuff. Keith Scott. I was actually going to do a few impressions for you now, but I'm not really in the mood tonight. I had a really bad nightmare last night. I dreamt that they actually dropped the bomb and they missed Wollongong. I've been having a lot of bad dreams. I dreamt I was doing a Royal Command performance last night and I got heckled by the fucking Queen. My husband and I would like you to piss off. And then Charles joined in, you know, sort of, fuck off. Wouldn't it be really great if Charles actually worked out how to put a fucking condom on? Probably couldn't get it over his ears. Have I got an act for you, ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Punchbowl. No expense to the management, from Punchbowl. The only place in the world where the local library's got a liquor license. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen. The one, the only, Mr. Vince Sorrenti. Come on, make a mark for Mr. Vince Sorrenti!
My name's Vince, I'm from Punchbowl. There's a picture of me as a baby. And I was a cesarean birth. I always leave the house through the window. Thank you very much. I'm eating hummus, I love tabbouleh, and I reckon Turkish coffee tastes divine. I've got a flick knife, I love karate, and I'm going out to discos all the time. I've got a 2-foot long steel bar, I like to decorate my car. I think I'm turning Lebanese, I think I'm turning Lebanese, I really think so. Shooting families, I think I'm shooting families, I really think so. No pies with sauce, no cricket, no surf. I don't go down to the pub after work anymore. Everyone around me is an Aussie bastard. I wanna plant a bomb in Double Bay and blast it. Turning Lebanese, I think you had to be there. Yeah, had to be there. I strolled into the showroom. I said, I'll have that red Ferrari, please. I pushed the old car off the edge of a cliff. I thought I'd won the lottery. I told the boss to shove it. As I strolled out of the factory, I bought my girl a dozen mink coats. I thought I'd won the lottery. I thought I'd won the lottery. The cunts, they played a trick on me. It's a useless bet. I'm $100,000 in debt. Yeah, had to be there. Ladies and gentlemen, my name's Vincent from Punch Bowl, and here's a picture of me as a baby right here. I actually wrote a song about Punch Bowl, and goes to the theme of New York, New York. And it's called Punch Bowl, Punch Bowl. So here we go. Da 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 da. I'm mowing the lawn. Da 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 da. I'm washing the car. I wanna be a part of it in old Punch Bowl with panel vans green. Da 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 da. And paintings obscene. I watch them drag at traffic lights in old Punch Bowl. I want to sleep in a suburb that never wakes, because this place is boring. I'm king of nothing. I must escape from this miserable place. Da-dum! Big finish! Mutilated red phones. Da-da-da-da-da! Concrete garden gnomes. You have your choice of fibro or triple-fronted brick homes. If you can make it there, there is cause for despair in old Punch Bowl. Punch Bowl. But you had to be there. Social comment, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Let's have a show of hands here. Who's actually ever been at the Punch Bowl here? Okay, now keep your hands up if you've been as far west as Cabramatta. It's not the end of the world, mate, but you can fucking see it from there, I'll tell you. The people out there are so stupid! We did this gig at the Cabra Vale Ex-Servicemen's Club. Thank God for the Vietnamese! That's all that's holding that joint together, Fannigan. The people are so stupid! We walked into this pizza parlour about 2 hours before the show, right, to get something to eat. And we're standing there, and this very tough Cabramatan family walked in, right? There was mum and dad, 18 and 19 years old, with the tattoos and that, right? And their seven-year-old kid. And they're so stupid! I looked down, the kid's only got one thong on, right? So I said, what's the matter, mate? You lose a thong? He said, nah, fucking found one. So stupid! So we go back to this very lovely Cabramatan home, right, for a very charming Cabramatan family dinner. And we're sitting around this Cabramatan family table, right? I'm sitting next to this four-year-old Cabramatan girl with the tattoos and that. All of a sudden, she yells out, pass the fucking salt! Her father smacks her in the head with a brick and says, you say please when you want the fucking salt! Look at the kids. They're so happy. It's 6 months now since John passed away. Things were looking pretty bad
before John died. Mortgage on the house. Payments on the car. The kids' school fees. Bills. The situation was pretty grim. Then along came the AMP man. He told us John's life insurance was worth $100,000. Well, me and the kids thought about it for a while. And then we cut John to fuck with a meat cleaver. Kids go to a private school now. I married the AMP man. And we're all going to the Caribbean. AMP helped me. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, my name's Vincent from Punch Bowl. There's a picture of me as a baby. Have we got any Italians in the audience here tonight? Any Italians here tonight? Mate, you'd lower the land values in Mount Druitt. You're not very attractive. You believe it? You believe it? You believe it? I don't believe it. I seen it, but no. I don't believe it. You believe it? I don't believe it. Unbelievable. I seen it, but I don't believe it. My husband, she said to me, she said, listen, I seen it, but I don't believe it. I've been to the supermarket. I'm coming out the checkout point. The lady, he shortchanged me 2 cents, 2 bloody cents. That's all right, I forgive. But I never forget. Unbelievable. Every night, I like to go dancing in the club. Unbelievable. I'm coming across the harbor bridge. The man stopped me and she said, 20 cents. I look at her and I said, you bloody bastard. Unbelievable. Every night I like to drink in the club with the boys. Come on, bring some beer. We drink, 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 drink. More beer, drink, drink, drink. More beer for the boys. Drink, 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 more beer, drink, drink. Then I drive home. I get in my car, no problem. I drive, fucking problem. I come home, I knock on the door. My wife answered the door. He look at me. And he said, what on the hell have you been? Unbelievable. I seen it. I hear it, but no. I don't believe it. When I'm at home, I like to fart. I sit, I fart. Sometime, my wife come in. He look at me. And he said, look, hear the smell. Unbelievable. I walk into the fruit shop. I said, how you going, mate? She said, all right, mate.
I said, you got any fresh fruit, mate? Oh, fresh fruit, mate. I said, just a minute, mate. This fruit tree is not fresh. It's all fresh fruit. Bye, or you get the fuck. Oh, mate, thanks very much. But just a minute. This fruit tree is not fresh. Get the fuck. So I went out. I came back in. I said, hey, mate. You got any tomatoes? No. No, tomatoes. Thanks very much. I went out, I came back in, I said, hey, Mai! You got any tomatoes? No. Thanks very much. I went out, I came back in, I snuck up behind him, I went, hey, Mai! You got any tomatoes? And she said, listen! You take the G out of grape, what do you got? I said, right. He said, you take the fuck out of tomatoes, so what do you got? I said, there's no fucking tomatoes. Unbelievable. I seen it, I hit it, but... Unbelievable. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, my name's Vince Sorrenti. I'm from Punch Brothers, Pitch of Music Baby. It's been my pleasure to be here tonight. Thank you very, very much. Thank you.
Mr. Vince Sorrenti.
Thanks very much.
Vince Sorrenti.
I've got an act for you now, ladies and gentlemen, that's, well, he's been around, he's worked clubs all over the country, he's worked clubs in Britain, the United States, South Africa. In fact, this guy would probably be the most experienced barman. I've ever had the pleasure of working with. The one, the only. Make him welcome. Come on, get a bit of energy going for Gary Who. Come on, give him a hand. Gary Who.
Thank you very much. Very nice to be here. Actually, I only come to the Comedy Store for kicks. I mean, it's the only place I know where a woman gets raped every 60 seconds. Do you know that, honey? Got a minute? Great tits. What happened to your hand? You got your hand in plaster. What happened? Shit! Good boy. What happened to your hand? What happened to your hand? What happened? That's your right hand. What? Jesus Christ. Sit down. Your wife's got two assholes, you're one of them. This chick here, she never learned to swim. She couldn't keep her mouth shut fucking long enough. Now, behave, girls. What are you doing? What are you out now? A bit of a night, girls' night out, is it? You with? Yeah, the boys don't want to know you. I don't blame you. You're fucking ugly. Since I'm ugly women in my time, they're ugly. Here's the waiter. How are you? Where's your tray? Oh, slack night, is it? You're a slack boy. Your hand's in plaster. It bothers me. What's wrong with your hand? Wanker's disease. You and me could, Oh, with her. Oh, lesbian friends. Girls not out. What are you laughing for? You're probably a lesbian too, are you? I know you're with a bloke. Then again, not really what you call a bloke, is it? Actually, I was sitting up the back. I looked down. You look like a poof from the back. I wasn't sure. I come up the front. You look like a poofter. You're a good fella. Shit! He's a good fella. This fella's a good fella. That's it. Cough all over the bastard. Actually, I'd piss on him if I were you. I'd never say anything about it. Is that your best gear you wear out? No wonder you don't get a fuck. Look at it. No wonder you ended up with her. Jesus Christ. Hey, you're a good fella. You're a good sport. A lot of people would have jumped up and hit me for saying something like that. Not you. You just sat there, you gutless bastard. Hey, honey. You got a cute smile, eh? Is that your husband there? Is it? Oh, well, I'm lucky. I hope he's got money. Is it really your husband? I was going to say, he's got a hand on her box. That's your sister. Yeah, well, fuck anything I say. Fuck's a fuck. Hey, egg face. Who are you rooting on the table? Who? You what? What? What the fuck did he say to me then? What, you from Lebanon? Sorry? Well, who said that to me? Good. Like some intelligent people come to the comedy store, is there? How are you, man? Camera number 3. Pain in the ass, I hate him. Now you walk into some rooms, you see people you don't like. I fucking didn't like him. Just hated him, man. Actually, I've had a terrible night. I went out to the car tonight to come here. You know, you walk out of the car, you hop in, like anyone normally does, open up the door, hopped in, started up, I get a mile down the road, Parramatta Road, big set of lights, right at the front, red light, green light turns, car stalls. I thought, oh shit. I'm trying to start it. You know, and they all start, get fucked! You know how you do that? It's really easy to remember. So get fucked! And they all start, you get fucked! You get fucked! You get fucked! Then everyone gets into it, even the pedestrian walking across says, get fucked! Where'd you get your fucking license from? A fucking Kellogg's cornflake packet? You're like an idiot! Get fucked! Get fucked! Get fucked! And they drive off. That's better. They think you want to be there. I'm trying to start. Finally, a copper pulls up. Right, typical copper. Gets out of the car. Walked up very slow because he works for the government. Lights kept changing, orange, red, green, orange, red, green. Sticks his head in the window and said, what's the matter? Haven't we got a colour you fucking like? Now, they do that. They do that because they want you to give them some cheek, right? So they can book you. That's what they do it for. But I fucked him. I said, officer, get fucked. He still booked me. In the future, I'm going to say what I feel. Stuff him. Anyway, he said, where do you come from? I said, Mudgee. He said, you're an Aussie. I said, yeah. And he said, you're driving a Holden car. I said, yeah. He said, have you got a manual? I said, yep. He said, well, you could fix it yourself. I said, right. I know if I can do it. So I got out of the car, walked around the front, opened up the bonnet. I got oil out. I stuck my head under. I'm trying to fix it, and this drunk walked up. He said, what? What? Because that's what they do. I know, because that's what I do. You say, what? Have you ever noticed when you throw up, there's always carrots in it? Have you ever noticed when you throw up, you lose respect for things, too, like, bleh! Couldn't give a shit about me new shoes. Anyway, I got a cab. Any cab drivers here tonight? Get out. I hate the bastards. I hate it when you get in the cab and the meter goes so quick and they go so slow. And you sit there and you don't want them to catch you looking at the meter because you feel like a Jew. So you sit there like this. I just want to turn around and say to them, will you fucking hurry up? But I don't. I just sit there with a really nice face and inside I'm going, asshole. Anyway, we got here all right, and actually it's my wedding anniversary tonight, folks. I've been married for 2 years tonight, and we're not together anymore. I woke up about 4 weeks ago and she pissed off my best mate. Shit, I miss him. Yeah. Actually, I can handle the rejection of it all, because I've had a lot of rejection in my life. I remember when I was a kid, my mother wouldn't breastfeed me. She told me she just wanted to be friends, you know. Well, I was an ugly kid. I don't blame her. Shit, my pimples were that bad. I fell asleep in the library one day. I woke up, there was a blind man reading my face. Shit, I was an ugly kid. I'm still ugly. Funny how you don't grow out of some things. But so now I'm on the beat, you know, I'm looking for a woman again. It's really a tough business. I mean, there are any guys here that have just recently broke up with their missus, including the guy scratching his ass on the way out for the piss. You know what I'm going through. It's a really tough thing to get back in the swing of picking up a woman, you know, or a woman pick up a man, because you forget the little things you got to do. I got all dressed up the first night. I forgot about the dress. I thought three-piece suit. I was really hanging out for a root, and I thought I'll get the three-piece suit out of the closet with the muff holes in it and put aftershave under the balls, you know. You don't know what sort of sucker you're going to pick up. And I was standing at the bar, and they didn't come near me. And I thought about it. I thought, shit, that's what I'm doing wrong. You've got to look rough. It's the animal. They like the animal. You know, ball hanging out your left short with hair on it. Ball hanging out your right short, no hair on it. That's my specialty. I always do that. Works. But I thought, I want to be ready in the underwear department because I hate it when they get you home and they spot the skid marks on your undies. What's that? Nothing. Truck backed over me last week. Anyway, so I bought some new underwear, right? Got them home, took them out of the packet, put them on. There was a rip in the ass. I thought, stuff it. 50 cents is 50 cents. I'm taking them back to St. Vincent's. I took them back. I said to the lady, look, I bought some underwear here last week and there's a rip in the ass. She said, well, bring them back. I said, well, as a matter of fact, I come at them. She said, I don't care if you're shitting them, bring them back. I don't have any luck. Do not have any luck. How are you, pal? Welcome back. Hey, you, piss face. Hey! Well, get fucked then! Another one I didn't like. You and him want to get together and do a double act. You can throw the stick and he can catch it, mate. Okay. I'm really pissed off. Well, I just had no luck at all. I went to the movies and I thought, I'd pick a route up at the movies. It happens at the movies. I went to the big one, the Hoyts. I thought, five cinemas? Doesn't happen in one, I'll keep moving. So I sat up the back row, right? This old bloke sat next to me, really old, about 95 or something, and this terrible smell. I couldn't help myself. I said, you dirty old bastard. Did you just shit yourself? He said, yeah. I said, well, why don't you move? He said, I haven't finished yet. Jesus Christ. And it costs so much to take a woman out. You notice how much it costs to take a woman out? Cost heaps. I mean, you take a woman out, you ask her for a drink. So, would you like a drink? They always go for the dearest. Yes, I'll have a Harvey Wallbanger. They don't know the thought that travels from the mind to the wallet when they say that. Fucking bitch. But it cost us a lot of money. But that's where I reckon dogs have got it worked out. Dogs are really smart. You see a dog, he doesn't go up and spend any money on him. He just walks up and goes, that's the one I want. You ever notice, I notice that every time you're with someone you like, you feel a fart coming on. You ever notice that? And you can hear it. And you can hear it moving around looking for the hole. And you think to yourself, oh, fuck no. If I fart, I'll fuck this relationship for sure. You mustn't fart. Please don't fart. I love her. I love her. Shit. There's times like that I think to myself, shit, they can send a rocket to the moon, they can't cure the common fart. And you ever think about it? You don't even choose to fart. It chooses you. You're not the fucking victim. I fucked that up. You are the victim. Jesus Christ. You know what I really like, bud? When you're on your own. And you feel one coming on. A good one. Because you know one is a good one. Even though it's not out yet, you fucking know it's a good one. You say, fuck, if there was people around now, they would fucking hate me. But it's all mine. And it's a bit like a baked dinner. You don't have it very often. So you really get into it and you let it out. Ooh. Doesn't even go out down to the bottom of your pants. It just goes through the cotton. And you're really getting in. You go, ooh. Oh, is that all? Farts. Actually, the first girlfriend I ever went out with, she invited me home to her place for dinner, and she was a pretty ugly sort of girl. Because, well, you can can see why. I have that knack of picking up ugly chicks. She was a big, very fat girl, you know, and she had a job at the time on the milk run. Nothing permanent, just till the horse got better. You know. She was very big. She was that big she couldn't fit into the bathtub. She used to wait till it was dark and go through the car wash. She was a big girl. But she loved me. Actually, she took me to a lot of places I never would have been. She took me to my very first Tupperware party. Now, don't laugh, you can get a lot of good things. I got a pair of Tupperware underpants. I still got them. They're uncomfortable, but gee, they keep what you got fresh, I'll tell you. But she said to me, she said, you've got to come home and meet my mum and dad because they want to meet you, otherwise I can't go out with you anymore. I said, well, okay, all right. She said, they've invited you for a baked dinner. I said, well, what's on it? She said, oh, you know, the usual meat, gravy, pumpkin, potato, peas. I said, what? She said, meat, gravy, pumpkin, potato, peas. I said, I can't come. She said, why not? I said, peas make me pass wind. She said, what? I said, they make me fart. She said, well, you gotta come. I said, okay, I'll come, I'll leave the peas. She said, you can't do that, mum will get the shits. I said, I'll do my best. So I turned up the table, right, and her mother and father got big dollars. I've never seen so many big dollars. A nice house, big driveway. I walked in, nice furniture, beautiful teak table, cutlery. It was a change from the tent. I sat down at the table, mother this side, father that side, ugly down the end. I sat down, along come the meal. It was just like she said, meat, gravy, pumpkin, potato, fucking big pile of peas. So I got crafty, actually. I thought to myself, right, I'll eat everything up, right, and I'll leave the peas till last. So I did eat everything up, got to the peas. I thought, right, maybe if I take a small spoonful at a time, I could sneak a couple of them quiet ones out. You know those types, you can blame them on other people. Who did that? That cunt! You dirty bastard! When you have a shit and be numb with it. Anyway, so I picked up the small spoon. Picked up the small spoon, took the first spoonful. 5 seconds later, not even a quiet one. I thought, that's your luck for you. The old man lifted up the tablecloth, he looked under, he said, Rover! I thought, shit, he's blaming the dog. But fools rush in. I thought, I'd better take it easy. I'll take another small spoonful to see what happens. So I picked up the spoon again. 5 seconds later. He lifted up the tablecloth, he looked under, he said, Rover! I thought, fuck, that'll do me. I'll get rid of the lot while I'm hot. So I took the whole plate, just went. 5 seconds later, comma, red light, fuck the red light, fuck, I hate them end bits. He lifted up the tablecloth, he looked under, he said, Rover, get out from underneath the table before the dirty bastard shits on you. Ladies and gentlemen, my name's Gary Hu. Good night. God bless you. Thank you.
That's all we got for you. That's our show for tonight. Just like to thank you for being a really tremendous audience tonight. But that doesn't alter the fact that I can't wait to get the fuck out of here. Remember, if you're driving home, drive carefully because I'm driving too. And I'm ripped to the tits. How about a big hand for all the acts on? Come on, one big round of applause for all of them. Thank you very much. I'm Graham Pusey in the Comedy Store some other time. Good night.
Get fucked. I don't believe it.
Keep Australia green, fuck a frog.
Has anyone actually been to the Comedy Store?
That's all, folks.